I named this book The Brown Beatnik Tones because I was wondering what it would like to be a beatnik poet in 1950, 1960, in the middle of all that was going on and not being recognized, because I couldn't figure out where all the black beatnik poets were at that time. And the only poet I could think of any prominence during that time was Amiri Baraka, and he was called Leroy Jones back then. And so I got up on the stage and I was doing that, and a man screamed out in the back, "Bob Hoffman!" And I said, "Who the hell is Bob Hoffman?" Turns out Bob Hoffman was the baddest black beatnik poet and the baddest beatnik poet of the time. But it's good to know that there was somebody there. So this poem is called Tender. So she melts, and I catch all of her on the tip of my tongue. And she tastes like dark chocolate, sweet and lush, full and pressed tight. She tastes like my dreams of home, those North American dreams of home, of lavish African hips and lips, and Kool-Aid sweet and sticky. What? Blackberry Kool-Aid and dark chocolate and a woman, mostly like a woman humming while melting on slow burn, gently stirred and fed like ice cream melting. Yeah, chocolate blackberry, melted ice cream sucked slowly off a spoon that was carved in Africa by women with lavish hips and lips, conjured up in my North American Negro dream that I prayed to face flush in a melted bowl of you while you hummed and melted. And the drums, you always need drums for lavish hips to dance to. And I kiss you and you melt like a block of ice thrown into your inferno, face first simmering and smiling and living and dying. In that moment, I saw you become a North American Negro dream that tastes like melted chocolate, blackberry Kool-Aid, ice cream that I spend all day finding in new places with my tongue where it stuck to your face.